यस कार्यक्रमका साथमा नेपाल टेलिकम राष्ट्रको संसार ओखती साबुन जडीबुटीको शक्ति साबुन ओखती इनलाइटमेन्ट बोर्डिङ स्कुल फुल ब्राइट कन्सल्टेन्सी.
नमस्कार. गन्तव्य प्राप्तिको पहिलो यात्रा कार्यक्रम सहयात्रामा हार्दिक स्वागत छ. दर्शकवृन्द, कुनै पनि देशको समृद्धिको निम्ति त्यो मुलुकको आर्थिक अवस्था तथा व्यापार कस्तो छ भन्ने कुरा निकै महत्त्वपूर्ण हुन्छ. यही कुरालाई मध्यनजर गर्दै आज हामी मुलुकको वाणिज्य मन्त्रालयका गतिविधिबारे जानकारी गराउन गइरहेका छौँ.
Nepal is a geographically diverse, landlocked country strategically placed between two economic powerhouses, India and China. Spread over 147,181 square kilometers and comprising of mountains, hills and the plains, Nepal ranks 93rd among the biggest countries in the world. Nepal is rich in water resources, with more than 6,000 rivers flowing from highlands from north to southern plains. Nepal's theoretical capacity for producing power from hydropower projects is around 80,000 megawatts, out of which 43,000 megawatts is estimated to be economically feasible. Hence, Nepal has great potential in clean and green energy production through hydroelectricity. Similarly, Nepal has potential to capitalize the comparative advantages in labor-intensive sectors such as agro-based and carpets and textile industries. Approximately 65% of the population in Nepal is dependent on agriculture, and agriculture sector contributes to about 33% of GDP. However, due to the growing population and land fragmentation, agricultural sector has not been able to perform well as it should. About 25.1% of the population is below the poverty line. Since it is a landlocked country, Nepal is dependent on India for most of its international trade. Adding to the already difficult terrains, the road connecting to China has also been badly damaged in the April 2015 earthquake. Although trade contributes about 38.4% in the GDP, Nepal's international trade is mostly imports dominant, as imports amount to 35.1%, while exports amount to 3.3% of total merchandise trade. Thus, Nepali economy is suffering from trade deficit of as much as 32% of its GDP. Nepal's trade sector has been moving forward amongst many challenges. The government of Nepal formed the Ministry of Commerce in order to increase exports, which will help to reduce the widening trade deficit. Since its inception, the Ministry of Commerce has brought forward policies and programs to make Nepal an export-driven economy. The ministry has been working on improving trade performance that functions as a strong pillar to the national economy. Recognizing the fact that fostering trade is a cross-cutting issue, the ministry has been actively carrying out the role of facilitating for inter-agency coordination, and that with the private sector and mainstreaming trade in national as well as sectoral policies and strategies. Currently, Nepal exports wool carpets, ready-made garments, red lentils, polyester and other fabrics, textiles, glass, steel and tin products, handicrafts, silver jewelry, toothpaste, cardamom, tea, ginger, Nepali paper, leather, pashmina and herbs, among others. Nepal has been importing iron and steel, petroleum products, vehicles and spare parts, electric and electronic items, machineries and parts, raw material for plastic, raw palm oil, telecommunication products, chemicals, gold, fertilizers, airplanes and spare parts, soybean oil, ready-made garments, among others. The most income-generating export products are carpets. Carpets worth 80 million rupees were exported last fiscal year. However, iron and steel worth Nepali rupees 780 million and petroleum products worth 690 million rupees were imported. If such circumstances prevail, the economy is sure to falter. The biggest challenge, therefore, is to bring substantial increment to potential export products so as to prevent further economic crisis and to pave a path for perpetual economic development.
जति हामी एक्सपोर्ट वृद्धि गर्न सक्छौ त्यति नै इकोनोमीलाई ट्रेड सेक्टरले कन्ट्रिब्युट गर्न सक्छ र त्यसका लागि म्यानुफ्याक्चरिङ बेस एक्सपान्सन गर्नु जरुरी हुन्छ जसले प्रोडक्टिभ जॉब क्रिएसन गर्छ एम्प्लॉयमेन्ट पनि जेनेरेट गर्छ त्यसले अल्टिमेटली इकोनोमीलाई कन्ट्रिब्युट गर्छ अहिलेको स्ट्याटस हेर्दाखेरि हाम्रो इम्पोर्टको सिचुएसन असाध्यै एभ्री इयर बढ्दै गइरहेको छ एक्सपोर्ट स्ट्याग्नेन्ट भएर बसेको छ वृद्धि हुँदाखेरि पनि अलिकति इनसिग्निफिकेन्ट क्वान्टिटीमा वृद्धि भएको कारणले गर्दा ट्रेड डेफिसिट प्रत्येक वर्ष वाइडनिङ भएर गएको छ
Taking this into account, the Ministry of Commerce has taken a series of initiatives to promote exports so as to achieve sustainable and inclusive economic growth, poverty reduction, and facilitate in food security. The Ministry has been conducting programs focusing on four major areas, that is, supply capacity boosting and value chain development, development of trade-related infrastructure, trade facilitation and market promotion in close coordination and collaboration with relevant line ministries. The ministry recognizes the poor infrastructure as the bottleneck of Nepal's trade sector, resulting in too high trade cost in terms of time and resources. Nepal was among the 110 countries to ratify the landmark Trade Facilitation Agreement, TFA, at the WTO, which has already come into effect since 22nd February 2017. With the successful implementation of the TFA, landlocked developing countries, LLDCs, like Nepal, are expected to be the major beneficiary in reducing transport costs and enhancing the competitiveness. The Ministry of Commerce has been negotiating at the bilateral, regional, and multilateral levels to overcome the major barriers of trade sector of Nepal, such as challenges due to SPS and TBT related issues, and seize opportunities of trade liberalization. Under Nepal Trade Preference Act 2016, the United States of America has authorized special trade preferences for Nepal, which will grant duty-free market access for up to 66 types of items for 10 years, and various other agreements have been made for capacity building and upgrading of trade-related infrastructure. Also, formal efforts are being made to develop skill and capacity of customs offices in the border areas. Preparations are being made to open trade routes with China through Korala and Rasuwagadi transit points. A container freight station, CFS, is also being built in Tobhar. The ministry has involved itself actively in issues pertaining to trade and business, such as skill development and capacity building, accessible markets, and interactions with relevant stakeholders and private sector.
ट्रेड फेसिलिटेसन प्रत्येक स्टेजमा प्रोडक्सन युनिटदेखि मार्केटसम्म जाने जुन सप्लाई चेन छ लिङ्क छ त्यसका एभ्री स्टेजमा एट द बोर्डर बियोन्ड द बोर्डर बिहाइन्ड द बोर्डर सबैतिर फेसिलिटेसनका मेजर्सहरू पनि लिनुपर्छ त्यसपछि भनेको मार्केट प्रमोसनको काम गर्नुपर्छ नेपाली वस्तुलाई अन्तर्राष्ट्रिय बजारमा परिवर्तन गर्नको लागि बजार प्रवर्धनको काम पनि गर्नुपर्छ यो एरियामा मन्त्रालयले काम गरिरहेको छ
नेपाल बीइङ अ ल्यान्डलक्ड कन्ट्री इज कम्प्लिटली डिपेन्डेन्ट अन इन्डियाज कोलकाता पोर्ट फर इम्पोर्ट्स एन्ड एक्सपोर्ट्स अफ इट्स गुड्स The ministry has been making efforts on using India's Visakhapatnam's port so as to further ease trade, reduce trade cost, and create an alternate trade route. The former Prime Minister signed agreement on transit rights through China on his visit to China on March 2016 that has opened new opportunities for trade and its development. Furthermore, the government of India assured the former Prime Minister during his last visit to India of its support in overcoming trade challenges, thus creating more possibilities for the Nepali trade sector.
जुन नेपाल व्यापार एकीकृत रणनीति 2016 लन्च गरेर हामीले ल्याएका छौँ कार्यान्वयन गर्न ल्याएका छौँ त्यो बेलामा धेरै हामीले चाहिँ छलफल गरेका थियौँ हाम्रो मेजर ट्रेडिङ पार्टनरहरूसँग उनीहरूको बजारसम्म पुग्नको लागि ड्युटीका वालहरू क्रमशः कम भत्किँदै गएका छन् त्यस कारणले त्यो नन ट्यारिफ ब्यारियरहरू हटाएर हाम्रो वस्तुलाई बजारसम्म लाने एउटा चुनौती अर्को चाहिँ पूर्वाधार निर्माण गर्न रिसर्च मोबिलाइजेसन गर्ने र बनाउने यद्यपि त्यो काम चाहिँ गर्नु पर्छ त्यो भइ पनि राखेको अवस्था छ र अर्को प्रोडक्ट डेभलपमेन्ट र अलिकति म्यानुफ्याक्चरिङलाई एक्सपान्सन गरेर जब क्रिएसन गर्ने ती तिन चारवटा कुराहरू हाम्रो अगाडि चुनौती हुन् जसलाई गर्न सकियो भने अवसरमा परिणत गर्न सकिने स्थिति पनि छ.
The Trade Policy 2015, formulated by the Government of Nepal, aims at enhancing export competitiveness, which includes provisions aimed at promoting service trade, protecting intellectual property rights, and implementing decisions taken during the 9th Ministerial Conference of World Trade Organization. The policy also has directions to support for value chain development to enhance competitiveness of Nepali products, including those identified by the NTIS 2016. Similarly, the process of amending of Export-Import Management Act is in the final stage, which would be another milestone in terms of legal reforms initiated by the Ministry for creating conducive environment for trade. Nepal Trade Integration Strategy, NTIS 2016, is Nepal's third generation trade integration strategy, which is the revised and updated form of NTIS 2010. NTIS 2016 seeks to address the outstanding trade and competitiveness challenges confronted by the country's export sector. This strategy has identified actions to address protracted constraints in a number of cross-cutting areas, such as identifying, promoting, and increasing exports of goods and services with high export potential. The government introduced this strategy after extensive consultations and discussions with concerned ministries, development partners, private sectors, and stakeholders. The strategy was prepared with the technical support from the Enhanced Integrated Framework, EIF, at the World Trade Organization, Geneva.
I think we, the Nepal and EU, we're long-standing partners.
Yes.
I think we established diplomatic relations back in 1975. 1996, we signed our first cooperation agreement.
Yes.
And in 2002, we established a delegation.
Yes.
And so I think we have a very dynamic relationship. Of course, there's still potential for more in-depth growth and more, especially from the trade perspective, mm-hmm. more interaction.
Yes.
We are one of the largest development partners of Nepal, so I think in that perspective we are very long-standing and good partners.
The NTIS has been implemented with an aim to strengthen trade and export-enabling environment, focus on product development, and strengthen supply capacity of priority products, strengthen institutional capacity, trade negotiation, and inter-agency coordination, and build and enhance trade-related infrastructures.
NTIS भनेको नेपाल व्यापार एकीकृत रणनीति हो यो चाहिँ सबभन्दा पहिला DTIS को रूपमा 2004 मा हामीले फर्स्ट फेजमा इम्प्लिमेन्टेसनमा ल्याए थियौ अनि त्यसपछि सेकेन्ड फेजमा 2010 मा चाहिँ इम्प्लिमेन्टेसनमा आयो र अहिले रिसेंटली हामीले 2016 यो तेस्रो फेजको इम्प्लिमेन्टेसनमा हामी गएका छौँ यो भनेको के हो भने हाम्रो एक्सपोर्ट पोटेन्सियल एरियाहरू भएका अथवा एक्सपोर्ट पोटेन्सियल भएका प्रोडक्टहरूलाई अन्तर्राष्ट्रिय बजारमा प्रवर्धन गर्ने गरी हामीले प्रायोरिटाइज गर्नु पर्यो अब सबभन्दा पहिला त हाम्रा मेजर एक्सपोर्ट पोटेन्सियल आइटमहरू आइडेन्टिफाई गर्ने तिनीहरूको प्रोडक्ट डेभलपमेंट गर्ने अनि त्यसपछि बजारसम्म लाने कामको लागि फोकस ग्रुपमा गभर्नमेन्टका विभिन्न मिनिस्ट्रीहरूले कोअर्डिनेटेड रूपमा कार्यक्रमहरू अगाडि बढाएर कार्यान्वयन गर्ने मूल उद्देश्यका साथ NTIS आएको छ.
Various policies are being devised for institutional capacity building for trade, including capacity for trade negotiations, business environment for investment and trade, trade and transport facilitation, standards and technical regulations, sanitary and phytosanitary measures, intellectual property rights, and issues related to trade in services to promote exports so as to achieve sustainable and inclusive economic growth.
EU has recently from Germany taken over this role. What is EIF? It's the Enhanced Integrated Facility, but basically it's about mobilizing and coordinating support for aid for trade. Here we see our role to help the government to make best use first of this facility, but also to mobilize in a larger sense cooperation for having a better trade environment.
EIF National Steering Committee has been established under the chairpersonship of the Minister of Commerce to ensure effective coordination for implementation of NTIS 2016 through policy and strategic guidance and resource mobilization. The committee comprises of Chief Secretary as the co-chairperson. Members include secretaries of concerned ministries and National Planning Commission, the Deputy Governor of Nepal Rashtra Bank, President of the Chamber of Commerce, and the President of the Federation of Nepali Chambers of Commerce and Industry. The Head of Division of the Ministry of Commerce, Planning and International Trade Cooperation serves as the Member Secretary. The committee focuses solely on fulfilling the agendas of the NTIS 2016. The committee has been directed to implement actions so as to attain short-term goals by 2018 and medium-term goals by 2020. As part of its initial task to formulate Nepal Trade Integration Strategy 2016, the government of Nepal conducted a thorough review of progress and shortfalls following the implementation of NTIS 2010. The NTIS 2016 is the updated and revised form of the NTIS 2010.
We see that development cooperation to a large extent should help to also foster inclusive economic growth. Mm-hmm. And here in Nepal, we see that in particular agriculture, tourism, but also trade have a lot of potential for this inclusive growth and job creation. We are embarking to work together with the government to implement the agriculture development strategy. Mm-hmm. And more concretely, when it comes to Ministry of Commerce, we are here engaged in the capacity development strategy to help the MOC to increase its capacity for trade negotiations, but also to oversee a better quality infrastructure and to stimulate value chains.
This strategy also aims to increase the competitiveness of the Nepali service sector. For example, the tourism sector. The tourism sector is an important component of the overall Nepali service trade. The NTIS 2016 has outlined the potentials for product and value chain development of 9 potential export goods and 3 services. Cardamom, ginger, tea, medicinal and aromatic plants, all fabrics, textile, yarn and rope, leather, footwear, pashmina and carpets are the priority export potential goods, and IT, BPO and IT engineering, tourism, skilled and semi-skilled professionals at various categories are the priority export potential services identified by the strategy.
Nepal ko hastakala bida bhaneko Nepal ko maulik kala pani ho. Yo sthaniya kacha padartha ra sthaniya sip ma adharit udyog ho. Yo kshetra lai rajya le vishesh प्राथमिकता क्षेत्रमा राखिएको खण्डमा यसले गरिबी न्यूनीकरण गर्ने स्वरोजगार सिर्जना गर्ने र राष्ट्रको पहिचानलाई बढाउने काम चाहिँ गरिरहेको पाइएको छ हस्तकलाका सामानहरू अहिले हाम्रो डाटा अनुसार झन्डै 80 वटा भन्दा बढी मुलुकमा चाहिँ एक्सपोर्ट भएको पाइएको छ
नेपालले नै अन्तर्राष्ट्रिय जगतमा चाहिँ अन्तर्राष्ट्रिय मार्केटमा पश्मिनाको चाहिँ पहिचान गरेको हामीले नै नेपालबाट नै भएको थियो नेपालबाट पश्मिनाजन्य वस्तुहरूको निर्यात जुन छ देशकै अन्तर्राष्ट्रिय बजारमा करिब करिब 70-80 मुलुकमा हुन्छ
Similarly, the NTIS has included IPR, which is an important subject to the trade sector. Hydroelectricity that holds tremendous potential to the Nepali economy has also been included in the other priority export potential sectors in the NTIS 2016.
Nepalko antarrashtriya byapar, antarik byapar, lai prabardhan garne, vikas garne, sahajikaran garne, ra trade sector lai economy ko one of the major pillars ko rupma establish garne, ra contribute garne. Aile pani tapaiko hamro total GDP hernu bhayo bhane, karib karib 22 arab American dollar bhaneko, 22 kharab barabar ko cha. Tesma trade sector ma hamro chahi merchandise item ra service sector ko contribution 53% cha. Banijya mantralayale aba इकोनोमीलाई कन्ट्रिब्युट गर्ने गरी इस्टाब्लिस गर्ने ट्रेड सेक्टरलाई प्रोडक्टिभ जब क्रिएसन गराउने अनि त्यसपछि आएर इकोनोमी ग्रोथ ट्रेड लेट इकोनोमिक ग्रोथलाई इन्स्योर गर्ने काम गर्छ ओभरअल ब्रोडर अब्जेक्टिभ यही हो यही हिसाबले हाम्रो पोलिसी पनि फर्मुलेसन भएको छ र रणनीति कार्यान्वयनको अवस्थामा रहेको छ
The Enhanced Integrated Framework is a framework under the WTO that implements a support program called the Aid for Trade, AFT initiatives, which works on 51 LDC countries, including Nepal, to upsurge trade capacity.
I think it's very interesting if you look at the long-term relationship we have with the government of Nepal. Many years ago, let's say 20, 25 years ago, we had a very much a project approach. We used to give support, for example, in the agricultural sector or in the renewable energy sector through a project-based approach. Yes. Then over the years, we turned to sector budget support, especially in the education sector.
Yes.
And also our portfolio really grew substantially from the last framework running until 2013,
yes.
We had over 7 years, 120 million euros.
Mm-hmm.
The current phase, which runs until 2020, we have tripled this, so that's 360 million yes. euros mm-hmm. as bilateral support.
The NEC Trade project, in operation since 2010 under the EIF, has been supporting trade mainstreaming, donor coordination, and institutional capacity for trade capacity building. The objective of the project is to support in institutional capacity building, which ultimately ensures faster growth of the country, alleviation of poverty through creation of jobs, and enhanced sustainability of trade development efforts, resulting in greater overall benefit to the Nepali through enhanced global integration, trade development, and proposed positioning of the country.
आयात र निर्यातको रेसियोलाई वाञ्छित दरमा अथवा सन्तुलित दरमा मात्रै कायम गर्न सकियो भने व्यापार घाटा कम हुने स्थिति रहन्छ इम्पोर्ट चाहिँ कन्ट्रीको रिक्वायरमेन्ट अनुसार आउने गर्छ इम्पोर्ट आफैमा अलवेज अब यो नराम्रो कुरा पनि होइन यदि इम्पोर्टलाई हामीले म्यानुफ्याक्चरिङ सेक्टरलाई कन्ट्रिब्युट हुने गरी अथवा इन्डस्ट्रियलाइजेसनलाई क्रिएट स्टिमुलेट गर्ने गरी कन्टेन्टहरू इनपुटहरूलाई मोबिलाइज गर्न हामी सक्यौँ भने त्यसले फेरि अर्को इन्डस्ट्रियलाइजेसनको प्रोसेसलाई कन्ट्रिब्युट गर्छ
The following projects are currently in operation under the Nepal government's Ministry of Commerce and Supplies. Nepal Enhanced Capacities for Trade and Development, N Project, supported by Enhanced Integrated Framework, WTO. The Nepal-India Regional Trade and Transport Project, NIRTTP, supported by the World Bank. Trade and Private Sector Development, TPSD, funded by the European Union, and the Trade Promotion Program, supported by the Federal Ministry of Economic Cooperation Development, BMZ, of Government of Germany. These projects focus basically on support in capacity development, development of quality infrastructure, and implementation of NTIS 2016 Action Matrix.
As far as trade relations are concerned, I think there is room for improvement. We are the second largest export market for Nepal. We're also helping the government of Nepal through, for example, a trade facilitation project
yes.
Where we are focusing on the coffee sector,
mm-hmm.
The value chain for coffee growers, mm-hmm. and we feel that this has very much potential for small farmers.
Mm-hmm.
But I think in terms of exports, there are many challenges. I think what Nepal exports to Europe is mainly confined to carpets, to garments, spices, tea, coffee hopefully will come up.
Mm-hmm.
But here is, I think, where we still want to work together to help the growth potential.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, on our side, we mainly export technical engineering material, etc., machine products. So I think we're doing well. We have a few European Chambers of Commerce that are working very well. But of course, as EU, we want to do our best to help the government really look at this potential and work even more together.
The Trade and Export Promotion Center under the Nepal government has been conducting various programs to increase trade, such as participation in national and international business trade fairs and trainings on capacity building since 2006.
निर्यातमा हामीले आशा गरेको जस्तो सफलता पाउनलाई हामीले धेरै मेहनत गर्नुपर्ने हुन्छ विशेष गरेर हाम्रो इकोनोमी अहिले आयातमा निर्भर भएको हुनाले र हाम्रो देशमा विभिन्न विकासका कामहरू गर्नुपर्ने भएको हुनाले र हामीसँग स्रोत साधनको कमी भएको हुनाले सम्बन्धित प्रोडक्टहरू हामीले विदेशबाट आयात गर्दाखेरि निर्यात हाम्रो थोरै देखिएको स्थिति हो निर्यात बढाउनको लागि हामीले उत्पादन तहदेखि लिएर निकासी तहसम्म विभिन्न प्रक्रियागत कुराहरू हामीले सञ्चालन गरिराखेका छौँ विभिन्न क्षेत्रमा गएर अन्तर्राष्ट्रिय व्यापार मेलामा पार्टिसिपेट गर्ने देखि होस् र व्यापारीहरूलाई ट्रेनिङ दिएर सशक्त जनशक्ति उत्पादन गर्ने कुरामा होस् र हाम्रो ट्रेडमार्क रजिस्ट्रेसन गराएर अन्तर्राष्ट्रिय क्षेत्रमा त्यसको पहिचान गराउने कुरामा होस् हामीले यसमा निरन्तर लागिपरेका छौँ
Commercial ties with various national agencies as well as financial support by international agencies has helped implement various projects, which has been significant in paving paths for overall trade development in Nepal.
व्यापार घाटा घटाउनलाई एउटा त हाम्रो यो जुन यो फ्युलहरू इम्पोर्ट भइरहेछ त्यो फ्युलको ठाउँमा अब इलेक्ट्रिक जुन अब लोड सेडिङ र इलेक्ट्रिकको हामी सफिसियन्ट भइरहेछ अब इलेक्ट्रिक गाडीहरू र इलेक्ट्रिक घराइ सामानहरू इलेक्ट्रिकबाट चल्ने जति छ त्यसलाई प्रयोग गर्दै जानु पर्यो र इलेक्ट्रिक गाडीदेखि लिएर सबै त्यो दर्तादेखि लिएर त्यो इम्पोर्टदेखि लिएर अन्तशुल्कदेखि त्यसको पार्ट्सदेखि लिएर ब्याट्रीदेखि सबैमा फ्री गर्नु पर्यो अनि पछि यो अब ठुल्ठुला गाडीहरू पनि इलेक्ट्रिक गाडीहरू चलाउनु पऱ्यो बजारमा र नेपाल सरकारले अब निजी क्षेत्रले पनि गर्नु पऱ्यो र अहिले गर्न सक्ने सरकारले पनि कुन लेभलसम्म सबैले इलेक्ट्रिक गाडी चलाउनु पऱ्यो बजारमा होइन त्यसले गर्दा हाम्रो व्यापार घाटा एउटा त फ्युलहरूमा कन्जर्सन र इन्भाइरोमेन्ट पनि राम्रो हो हामीले केही पनि गर्नु पर्दैन दुई ठुला देशका त्यसको जनसङ्ख्याको 0.1% मात्रै दुबईले पर्यटन पठाइदियो भने हामीलाई औला दौला हुन्छ त्यो अनुसारको हामीले चाहिँ नि पर्यटन सेवा र त्यो अनुसारको पर्यटनको लागि उद्योग व्यापार मात्रै गर्न सके पनि हामीलाई काफी हुन्छ भारतसँग हाम्रो त्यत्रो बायोलेटर ट्रेड एग्रिमेन्ट भएछ र चाइनामा 8030 आइटमको एक्सपोर्ट गर्दा जिरो ट्यारिफ छ यी सबैको हामीले चाहिँ नि बेनिफिट लिएर एक्सपोर्ट गर्नेतिर ध्यान दिनु पर्यो सरकारले यो कहाँ कहाँ हामी कमजोर छ र किन यो भइ नराखेको भनेर त्यो ठाउँ पत्ता लगाएर त्यतातिर पहिला अमल गरेर त्यतातिर गयो भने हाम्रो व्यापार घाटामा अलिकति सहजीकरण हुन्छ
Substantial development to the communication technology has made the world a small place. In the current situation, any achievement in a small region can affect everyone else. International cooperation in eradication of extreme poverty and inequality has been stronger than before. As such, several global attempts are being made to support economically disadvantaged countries. Innumerable steps implemented by the Nepal government to curb trade deficit by strengthening exports and cutting back on imports by import substitution hold high prospects. The Trade Policy 2015 and Nepal Trade Integration Strategy 2016 would be instrumental in increasing the contribution of trade in the national economy. Particularly in achieving export-led growth and address the rising trade deficit, outstanding trade and competitiveness challenges confronted by the country's export sector. The international community has been helping immensely in attainment of goals by extending its support to this attempt of the Nepal government.
Another sector yes. where I think there is a lot of potential is tourism. Yes. If you see the European tourists account for the second largest number of tourists to Nepal in 2006, 150,000 came from Europe. Mm-hmm. And there is of course enormous potential because this is such a beautiful country.
Yes. Our country holds tremendous potential for potential export products and resources. With support from stakeholders to attain more resources and technical support and its mobilization, resulting in competitive placing of products, it won't be too long before our trade performance improves significantly by increase in exports and reduction of trade deficit. The effective implementation of the Trade Policy 2015 and NTIS 2016 can bring about substantial change and development to trade, thus creating possibilities of a silver lining, which holds the key to the future of Nepal and of the Nepali people.
दर्शकवृन्द, यो प्रसङ्गपछि अब लागौँ यो अर्को प्रसङ्गतर्फ। चाङधु नृत्यसँग सम्बन्धित आफ्नो फिल्म गाउझाङमा सुरु भयो। चराहरू स्वतन्त्र रूपमा आकाशमा उडिरहे। हामी निकै आनन्दित मुडमा थियौँ। तिब्बतमा गाउझाङ निकै लोकप्रिय नृत्य हो। ऐतिहासिक सन्दर्भहरू हेर्दै आउँदा गाउझाङ नृत्य चाङधुमा उत्पत्ति भएको पाइन्छ। जब कुनै चाडपर्व आउँछ, मानिसहरू जम्मा हुन्छन् र उनीहरू आपसमा सर्कल बनाएर बडो आनन्दसँग यो नृत्यको मजा लिन्छन्। गाउ झाउको दुईवटा विशेषता छन्, गाउ भनेको गोलो र झाउ भनेको नृत्य। गलत अनुवादका कारण दुवै विशेषताहरू कहिलेकाहीँ गलत रूपमा बुझ्ने गरिन्छ। सामान्य शब्दमा गाउ झाङ एक गोलबद्ध नृत्य हो, सूर्य जस्तो गोलो भएर गरिने नृत्य। धेरै पहिले गाउझाङ नाच रातमा मात्र देखाइन्थ्यो, बीचमा आगो बालिन्थ्यो, अरू वरिपरि गोलबद्ध भएर नाच्ने गर्दथे। कुनै विजय उत्सव सेलिब्रेट गर्न यो नृत्य प्रयोग गरिन्थ्यो। कुनै बाजागाजा बिना 7-8 जनाको समूहले गोलो बनाएर नाच्ने गरिन्छ। कुनै पनि महत्त्वपूर्ण पर्व अवसरहरूमा सबै गाउँले आपसमा जम्मा भएर यो नाचलाई भने राम्रो र भव्य बनाउँछन्। बिस्तारै आगोको ठाउँमा सानो बत्ती मात्र बाल्न थालियो। नाचको समयमा राम्रा राम्रा खानेकुराले पनि स्थान लिन थाले। मानिसहरू जम्मा भएर नाचसँगै मिठा मिठा खानेकुरा पनि खान थाले। यस्तो बेला मासु र रक्सी बढी चल्थ्यो। रक्सी मासु खाँदै नाच्ने, थाकेर फेरि आराम गर्ने, फेरि खाने, फेरि नाच्ने, यस्तै यस्तै। यही जानकारीसँगै सहयात्राको आजको श्रृङ्खला यहीँ सकिन्छ। हामीलाई सहयात्रा TV.com लगइन गरेर पनि हेर्न सक्नुहुनेछ। हवस् त, गन्तव्य प्राप्तिको पहिलो यात्रा, चन्दा प्रोडक्सनको प्रस्तुति कार्यक्रम सहयात्रा निरन्तर जारी छ। नमस्कार।
यस कार्यक्रमका साथमा नेपाल टेलिकम, राष्ट्रको संचार, ओखती साबुन, जडीबुटीको शक्ति साबुन ओखती, इन्लाइटमेन्ट बोर्डिङ स्कुल, फुल ब्राइट कन्सल्टेन्सी।